onto erasure, though, there's a lot of other issues. I mean, the big one, the sequester just cut $50 billion from science funding over the next 5 years, and that is a very scary number. It's going to maim scientific inquiry and discovery. And I think we need to totally reverse that. And that's another generational issue for us. It's going to fall overwhelmingly on
the biggest generational issue for your generation is the debt. Yeah. I get so upset with young people who say, well, let's have more funding for this, more funding for that. If we don't do something about this debt, you're going to spend all of your time working just to pay off for the fiscal sins that we're committing today.
So, Stephen, I think you probably would agree with return on investment, right?
Right.
So I think science funding, yeah. There's a huge return on investment for funding science.
Right.
Way more than
But the private sector science is the one that matters the most. That's where all the innovation comes from. I mean, and we got to get
You can argue with some of the scientists on that, whether basic research is vital or not. I think it is.
Yep.
But either way, if we need to fund a lot of science, because it's like the president has been giving the example of mapping the human genome, offering $140 for every one that we spend. That's way more than any interest we pay for even borrowing to pay for that. That's an absolutely wonderful investment that we need to make.
So you think things like when the National Science Foundation spends money on snail mating habits and so on, that's a good use of
we've been
taxpayer
over this,
dollars.
We've been over this. You're not a scientist.
I'm not a scientist, but I know that we don't need to spend taxpayer dollars on snail research.
Actually, you don't know.
Yeah, I do know we should.
But the point is,
wait a second, how much is snail research out of the whole budget?
It's like a $2 million grant, but there are
$2 million.
And
where does the real money go to? See, this is always this argument, these anecdotal examples.
Wait a minute, Bill. Bill, you just said you don't want to cut. It's the biggest program in the budget, Social Security.
No, I didn't say that.
Well, what are we going to cut then? I mean, show it.
What about military spending?
Yes.
Okay.
There you go.
You've done that.
What about understanding that revenue now is a percentage of GDP?
Yeah,
I know that's all you talk about.
Right.
But maybe if we ask one out of four corporations in America not paying any taxes,
we have the highest corporate tax rate in the world, Senator.
No, we do not.
Yes, we do. 35%. The Tax Foundation says the United States of America has the highest
tax rate. And who funds the National Tax Foundation?
Whoa.
You guys talk about science. You're not. This is the science. We have the highest corporate tax rate.
Whoa. We have the highest
nominal. Not effective.
Right.
Not the
one
payments.
That's what really people pay is the lowest. It's 12%.
How much does General Electric pay? Zero.
That's why we got to totally overhaul the corporate taxes. We should have a flat tax and get rid of every deduction.
A second ago, we were paying the highest.
We have the highest statutory corporate tax rate.